Arnold is an unbiased, physically based ray tracing 3D rendering application. With Arnold, you get material, lighting, and rendering options. For this lesson, we'll focus on Arnold Light and Renderer. Start by opening Rendering D Start Max file. Go to the Renderer Setup, and from the Renderer's drop-down menu, choose Arnold. In the Create panel, Lights, from the drop-down menu, choose Arnold. Then choose Arnold Light. There's a single light, but within that light, there are many other light options. Go to the top viewport. Click to create a light in the center of the train station. Then, in the left viewport, move the light above the train station. Go to the Modify panel. First, rename the light Skylight. In the Shape section, choose from the light type drop-down menu Sky Dome. Before you render, go to the Rendering Environment dialog. Change the exposure control to physical camera exposure control. Uncheck use physical camera controls if available. And in the global exposure, change the exposure value to 14. Now close the dialog. Render the camera viewport. For this lesson, we're trying to create a nighttime scene, so the overall brightness needs to be adjusted. Select the skylight, and in the Modify panel, go to the Color Intensity section. First, change the Kelvin amount to 8500. This will create a cooler light, which works very well with nighttime scenes. Then, in the Intensity section, change the exposure to 4. Render the camera viewport. The render is dark, so we'll add a light for some contrast. Go back to the Create panel, and then choose Arnold Light. In the top viewport, create the light in the center of the light over the ticket booth door. Then in the front viewport, move it in the center of the light object. Go to the Modify panel, rename the light Ticket Booth Light. In the Shape section, change the type to Disk. Keep radius and spread at the default. In the Color Intensity section, change the Kelvin to 3800. This will warm up the light and create a nice contrast with the cool light of the skylight. If you render, the light barely shows. Back to the Modify panel. In the Intensity section, change the intensity to 3. And the exposure to 16. Render the camera. The lighting looks good, but the shadows show a lot of noise along the edges. In the Modify panel, Rendering section, change the samples to 4. This will slow the render down, but will smooth out the shadows. Select the camera viewport and select C. This will bring up a Select Camera dialog. Select the Fizz Cam 02. In the Scene Explorer, make sure it is set to Sort by Layer. In the default layer, select the Ticket Booth Light. In the top viewport, hold Shift and move the light so it sits under the train lamp object. In the Clone Options dialog, select Copy and rename the light Train Lamp Light 001. Then move the light up so it sits inside the light fixture. The train station monitor screen will need to be lighted to be visible at night. This will be done through the material. Open the Slate Material Editor. Load the monitor screen material into the slate using the eyedropper in the toolbar and click on the monitor screen. Double-click the material node title to load the material parameters. Select the red rubber band link between the bitmap and the material. When it turns white, delete that connection. Then drag from the bitmap output to the emissions color map input socket. In the base color section, change the color to black. In the emission section, change the amount to 1.0 and the luminance to 10,000. Select the camera viewport and render. The monitor screen is nice and bright, and there's some nice light coming from the copied light. Now let's get some lighting inside the train. Select the passenger cab hall GO002. Right-click in the viewport and choose Isolate Selection. In the Create panel, Lights, choose an Arnold light. In the top viewport, create a light in the middle of the passenger cab hall object. Move the light up into the cab to position it just under the ceiling of the train cab. In the Modify panel, rename the light Passenger Cab Light 001. Change the type to disk and the radius to 15. Change the Kelvins to 5600, the intensity to 8, and the exposure to 15. Having just one light won't be enough for this cabin, so hold Shift, move to copy the light. In the Copy Options dialog, choose Instance and Two Copies, then OK. Move the lights so they are evenly distributed along the inside of the passenger cab hall. Right-click, and from the quad menu, choose End Isolate. Render the camera viewport. This looks really good. It just needs a background image. In the Scene Explorer, unhide the image plane layer and render the camera viewport. Now it's perfect.